नानान्त्वा गणपतिगुं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनश्रृण्वन्मूतिभिः सीदसादनम् ॐ महागणपतये नमः सरस्वत्यै नमः श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम् श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति। स्टार्ट विद द टीका मंगलाचरण एज वेल। कैवल्यानंद योगींद्र शुद्धानंद यतीश्वरौ नत्वारभे लघुव्याख्याम् दक्षिणाशामुखस्तुतेः। You can do it together. You should not break the pada when it's a single word. So I'll just read it again. Kaivalyananda yogindra shuddhananda yatishvarau natvarabhe laghuvyakhyam dakshinashamukastutehe. So this Dakshinamurti Stotra has two tikas. There may be more also, but two famous tikas. One is called as Manasollasa by Sureshwaracharya. Sureshwaracharya was a direct disciple of Adi Shankaracharya, Bhagavatpadacharya or Bhagavan Bhashyakara. By all these names we address him. And he was the first Acharya of Sringeri Pitha also. So he has written this Manasollasa Tika on Dakshinamurti Stotra, which is there are 10 shlokas in the Stotra Mula, whereas the Tika, Manasollasa Tika is around 30 to 50 shlokas per shloka. Per shloka of the Mula, there are around 30 or 50 shlokas. It's quite vast, quite elaborate. And being in poetic form, it's a little complex also. Easy to chant, but difficult to understand at times. Whereas there is another Tika on it, which is on prose form. So prose form is generally, we are used to that. Those who have studied Bhashya, prose form in that. So that Tika is by Swayam Prakash Yati. So Bhagavan Swayam Prakash Yati has written this Tika, which mostly followed it is a second Tika in line, because he refers to Manasollasa also. So Manasollasa means Sureshwaracharya's in his mind, whatever Ullasa, whatever Spurana happened due to the shloka, in his mind, that is expressed in the form of Manasollasa Tika. The Tika by Swayam Prakash Yati is called as Tattva Sudha, but as in his prayer, he says, Laghu Vyakhyam Arabhe Natva, having bowed down to Natva, having bowed down to whom? Kaivalyananda Yogindra Shuddhananda Yatishwarau. So Yatishwarau, you see, there's a dual ending. It's a second case, dual ending. So there are two gurus that he is doing namaskara to. And we can assume that they were his gurus, Kaivalyananda Yogindra and Shuddhananda Yati. And the Shishya is named as Swayam Prakash Yati. Arabhya, I begin, he says. But what does he say? I begin Laghu Vyakhya. So Laghu Vyakhyam Arabhya. To Arabhya, Laghu Vyakhya is a karma. It's an object. So I begin the Laghu Vyakhya. So when he says Laghu, although the Tika is called as Tattva Sudha, Tatsudha is like a nectar of Tattva. Tattva is reality of Tattva. Tasya bhava of anything. Tat can be anything. It's a pronoun. So Tattva is reality of anything. Bhava of anything. What is the core essence of anything? Meaning reality. So Tattva Sudha is nectar of that reality, is the name of the Tika. And he says Laghu Vyakhya. It's a Vyakhya. It's a commentary. So Laghu Vyakhya, since he says Laghu, it is Laghu means it's a short, brief commentary. And he mentions at places that I am not going into details. We have covered elsewhere in elaborate detail. Now, this is a Laghu Tika. So therefore, it is called as Tattva Sudha as well as Laghu Tattva Sudha. Same Tika is called by both names. So there are Dhyana Shlokas before the Tika itself and the Mula itself. These Dhyana Shlokas on the deity, Dakshinamurti, these are from both Tikas. So, we don't know what is the origin of this. So, Ishwaro Guru Ratniti, for example, it may be from Manasollasa. And Mauna Vyakhya, the initial, this thing can be from Laghu Tattva Sudha. So, it's a mix of that. And in Sampradaya, a lot of these are chanted. So, we'll chant these and then begin. Does everyone know this or you want to repeat after me? Mauna Vyakhya Prakatita Parabrahma Tattvam Yuvanam. Mauna Vyakhya Prakatita Parabrahma Tattvam Yuvanam. Varshishtante Vasadrushad Ganair Avrutam Brahma Nishthaihi. Varshishtante Vasadrushad Ganair Avrutam Brahma Nishthaihi. Acharyendram Karakalita Chinmudram Ananda Rupam. Acharyendram Karakalita Chinmudram Ananda Rupam. Svatma Ramam Mudita Vadanam Dakshinamurti Mide. Svatma Ramam Mudita Vadanam Dakshinamurti Mide. Vata Vitapi Samipe Bhumi Bhage Nishannam. Sakala Muni Janana Jnana Datara Marat. Sakala Muni Janana Jnana Datara Marat. Tribhuvana Guru Misham Dakshinamurti Devam. Tribhuvana Guru Misham Dakshinamurti Devam. Janana Marana Dukkha Cheda Dakshan Namami. Chitram Vatatarur Mule Vruddha Shishya Gurur Yuva.
Chitram Vatatarur Mule Vruddha Shishya Gurur Yuva.
Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam Shishyastu Chinna Samshayah.
Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam Shishyastu Chinna Samshayah.
Nidhaye Sarva Vidyanam Bhishaje Bhava Roginam.
Nidhaye Sarva Vidyanam Bhishaje Bhava Roginam.
Gurave Sarva Lokanam Dakshinamurtaye Namaha.
Gurave Sarva Lokanam Dakshinamurtaye Namaha.
Om Namah Pranavarthaya Shuddha Jnanaika Murtaye.
Om Namah Pranavarthaya Shuddha Jnanaika Murtaye.
Nirmalaya Prashantaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha.
Nirmalaya Prashantaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha.
Ishwaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine.
Ishwaro Guru Ratmeti Murti Bheda Vibhagine.
Yoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha.
Yoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha.
मौन व्याख्या प्रकटित परब्रह्म तत्वम युवानम युवानम एंड वर्षिष्ठान्ते वसत ऋषिगणैः आवृतम ब्रह्मनिष्ठैः आचार्येन्द्रम करकलित चिन्मुद्रम आनंद रूपम स्वात्मा रामम मुदित वदनम दक्षिणामूर्तिम ऑल ऑफ दीज इन आर इन सामानाधिकरण्यम मीनिंग एन अपोजिशन दे ऑल हैव द सेम लोकस विच इज दक्षिणामूर्ति एंड इन एज एन ऑब्जेक्ट इन सेकेंड केस एंड द वर्ब इज ईडे अहम ईडे आई वर्शिप इट्स स्तुतौ वर्शिप और आई डू स्तुति ऑफ आई प्रेज द लॉर्ड हु इज दक्षिणामूर्ति So Dakshinamurti has many interpretations. It can be broken as Dakshina and Amurti as well as Dakshina Murti. So general meaning, simple meaning is Murti, Rupa, an idol, which is facing Dakshina Dik. Dakshina is south. So south is the direction of Mrityu. Generally, we are not supposed to face south and do any auspicious activity. But Dakshina Murti himself as a guru, as a lord, protects us from that mrityu by himself facing death. And this death is not necessarily the death of the body. Death of continuous birth and death. Death meaning continuous birth and death, the samsara. The continuous series of births and death. So he faces that for us and protects us from that. So that Dakshinamurti, aham ide, I Dakshinamurtim. I worship or I do stuti, I praise this Lord. And Amurti, if you take Dakshina, Dakshina also has the meaning of who is Daksha. Daksha means Samartha, he is capable. Capable to do what? Capable of creation, sustenance, and dissolution. All three. It's a single Ishwara who does everything. So he manifests the world, he sustains it, and he resolves it into himself. That kind of a Lord who is capable to do all of this, that is Dakshinamurti. And Amurti can be Murti and Amurti. He's, for us, he has taken a form. But really, he is Amurti. He has no form. He is formless. That Dakshinamurti, aham ide, I, it is, it, the dhatu is it's tutau. So, it's tutau, ide, I praise. And what kind of Lord is this Dakshinamurti? So, all the adjectives are added. First, Mauna Vyakhya Prakatita Parabrahma Tattvam. So, this is a person. So, Tattva means reality. He is one who has made it Prakatita. Made is Prakata. So, he is Prakatita means he has made it Prakata. He has made this Parabrahma Tattva. The reality of Parabrahma. Parabrahma is the highest reality. Brahman. Brahmi Vriddhav. That which is infinite. That infinite Tattva. Para, that tattva he has made prakata, so prakatita, by whom it has been made manifest. It, the entire tattva is made known by whom? Through what? Through mauna vyakhya. Mauna vyakhya. So mauna has also has multiple interpretations. So mauna is muni, munir bhavaha. Muni, the state of muni is called mauna. And generally we see that muni practices silence. So mauna has a rudhi artha of silence. It also means technically in Vedanta, the Parabrahma Tattva is something which cannot be expressed in words. It is not a vachyartha. If you cannot point it out that this is it, you know, this is it. You can show like Shaka Chandra Nyaya. Shaka Chandra is you can't see the moon on the, when it's near Amavasya, you cannot see the moon. Or Prathama, you just see just a little bit of Chandra. Somebody can see it clearly, but the other does not know. So how do you show to the person? You say that branch, do you see that branch? That branch is Chandra. That is Shaka Chandra Nyaya. That branch is not really Chandra. But don't you see this branch over here? Then he can see the branch and just next to that. So you point out through indirection. There's an implied meaning. Directly it cannot be expressed. It is beyond the speech and mind, as the Shruti says. So that is the meaning of Mauna, that he is taught something which cannot be taught by words. So how does he teach? It is as good as Mauna. Finally, in the end, it is Mauna. Once you know, you go into Mauna. There is nothing to talk about. There is nothing to express. There is no object, subject, object. Division vanishes because its entire tattva is one whole infinity. You are not a part of it. You are it because there is no other. So you is I am it. So when you get it, it is I am it. So this is how he teaches, and therefore it is Mauna. There is also a story, Pauranika, where Rishi Munis were having discussions and debates on Tattva. What is the real reality of this world? What is the philosophy? Philosophical debates. And then it became heated as to who wins. So they went to a guru. So this guru is Yuva. He is young guru who is an avatar of Shiva. Ishvara himself has taken a form of Dakshinamurti as a teacher. And he is sitting under a banyan tree. And they approach him. When they approach, they have a lot of all these ideas as this is it, and a lot of noise inside their head. And there's an eagerness to win. All that resolved in that Mauna, because he expressed that he influenced their mind by his presence, and they could see the reality. See in the sense, it is not really objectification, but see as in the way you see a point clearly, that clarity they got in his presence. So thereby also Mauna Vyakhya. Vyakhya is teaching through Mauna. So there is a literal meaning also which is possible. And through that Mauna Vyakhya, he has made this Parabrahma Tattva to become Prakata, clear to everyone in the Sampradaya. And he is the original teacher. So we say Sadashiva Samarambham. So Sadashiva is this Dakshinamurti avatar. As a teacher of Sadashiva is this Dakshinamurti. And he is a Yuva. All the rishis have lived for hundreds of years, but he is young. The teacher is young, while the students are old. So thereby Yuva. And Yuvanam is the second case for that. So that Yuva, Dakshinamurti, I praise. And who are these Rishi Munis, who are the students? They are Varshishtante Vasat. So Antevasat means Antevasi. Antevasi means they stay inside the Gurukula. They are called as Antevasi. Antevasat. And Varshishta means they are Vriddha. In Vyas also, in age also, they are Vriddha. They are aged. Or in all practices of Karmakanda and Upasanas and even philosophical studies, they Jnana Vriddha also. Jnana Vriddha means Jnanena Vriddha. Knowledge also, they have quite a bhandara of knowledge. But then reality, the end goal is lost on them. That comes only through this teacher who is a Yuva. So Varshishtante Vasad Rishi Ganehi Avrutam Brahmanishti. So these Avrutam, he is surrounded. So it's one word. Varshishtante Vasad Rishi Ganehi is one word. Avrutam. So one who is Avruta, one who is surrounded by whom? So Tritiya there, Ganehi. By the group of Rishis. Rishi Ganehi. There are a lot of groups of Rishis who are surrounding and who are Antevasis. And who are Jnana Vriddha as well as Vayasi Vriddha. And who are these? Now they are Brahmanishta. They are Brahmanishta. So Brahmanishtaihi Rishiganehi. So these are Brahman. So Brahmani Nishtha Yeshamte. So those who have Nishtha in Brahma. Their commitment is in Brahma, in Parabrahma, in the Atma Tattva. By them he is surrounded. You can see in any Dakshinamurti photo also, a painting, you see that Rishis are sitting surrounding him. And who is what? Acharyendra. Acharyendram in second case. So Acharyendra. He is Indra among all the Acharyas. He is a lord of Acharyas. He has taught all the Acharyas and he is also the best of Acharyas. And another thing, if you notice, if you have Chinmudra. He holds Chinmudra. So Karakalita Chinmudram. He is one who holds Chinmudra in his hand. So Karakalita. Through his hand he has made a Chinmudra. What does Chinmudra indicate now? The index finger is the Jiva. The thumb is the Parabrahma. So he joins them and shows that there is no difference between the two. So this is Advaita. And it also makes the seeker, Jiva, index finger, Purna with the thumb. which is Brihivriddho, Brahma is Purna. So when he joins there, and joining is figurative because he was never different. The Jiva was never different from Parabrahma. Thereby this Purnatvam is indicated by that circle. So that is Purnatvam, he indicates with the Chinmudra. So through that Chinmudra also he teaches that there is no difference between the Jiva and Parabrahma. Ananda Rupa. Ananda Rupam. So his Ananda Rupa. Rupa is Swarupa, not a form really. But if you say formless form of Ananda, Ananda is his very nature. That kind of a Dakshina Murti, who is also Swatma Rama. And how does he get Ananda? Ananda Rupa. Okay, is this Ananda borrowed Ananda? Is it Vishaya Ananda? Is it an Ananda which is derived from all the objects, the way we kind of derive, or we think that we derive pleasure from the objects? No. Swatma Ramam. Swasya Atmani. Swatmani Arama Yasya. One who has Arama, rest. We say Arama is rest. Who is resting in his own Tattva, Atma. And own Atma means there is no difference between own and Atma. This is what is called as in Vyakrana, we say that it is Rahoho Shiravat Shashti. The sixth case there of Swasya Atma. That Swasya Atma, my Atma. So my Atma connection is in sixth case in Sanskrit. So that sixth case is Rahoho Shiravat Shashti. Rahoho Shiravat means in Purana Kathas we heard Rahu is the head. When the Rakshasa was cut, then the Rahu is the head and the entire body is Ketu. So when you say the head of Rahu, Rahu is the head. The head is called as Rahu. You cannot have the head of Rahu because Rahu is the head. It will be like saying Rahu's Rahu. So that Rahu's head is just a usage. It's a usage, a phrase, but it means Rahu itself. Similarly here, Swasya Atma, my Atma means I. My and Atma, there is no difference between the two. My Atma means I am Atma. So Swatma, but how do you, it's a language usage, that's all it is. Swatma Ramam. So in one's own self, he has Arama. That kind of Dakshinamurti, therefore his Ananda is Swarupa. It's not a borrowed Ananda. It is own Swarupa. Mudita Vadanam. And he is not fiery or like other deities. You know? He has a smile on his face. He puts everyone at comfort. So Mudita Vadanam. His face is, he has a smile, smiling face. Very pleasant to look at form. Even the form that he has taken. Although a Murti, the Murti that he manifests in, that is Mudita Vadanam. That kind of Dakshina Murti I bow down to. Or I do stuti of. And where does he sit? In Vatavitapi Samipe. Under a, near a banyan tree. Bhumi Bhage. On the ground near the tree. Seated. Nishannam. He seated that kind of a. So Vatavitapi Samipe Bhumi Bhage Nishannam Dakshina Murtim. That Dakshina Murti who is seated near the banyan tree on the ground. And Jnana Dataram Arath. He is a Jnana Data. Sakala, to whom? Sakala Muni Janana. To all these Rishiganas who are sitting there, who are surrounded by Rishiganas. But is he just surrounded? Are they meditating upon him? Are they just sitting, watching him, sightseeing, whatever? So people are surrounded for whatever reasons, for Siddhis, for anything, you know. You can go to a Guru to ask for anything. Sakala Muni Janana Jnana Dataram. He is providing jnana. He is a jnana data. He is a giver of knowledge to whom all the munijanas, sakala munijanas. And arath. Arath is an avya, is an indeclinable, which is in close proximity. That's one meaning. Nikata is the meaning. So as a guru is directly addressing the shishya. So that's the proximity. Physical proximity. The other is what he teaches is arath is nikata, that tattva, that everything is one. It is so close that there is no difference between the two. The guru and shishya, they become one. That is that arath there. Tribhuvana Guru Misham, and he is Isha, he is Ishwara. Is he Ishwara for like everyone has their own Ishwara, my Lord, that is your Lord. Tribhuvana Guru. He is Isha, he is Tribhuvana Guru Misham, he is Guru and Ishwara for all the three worlds, whether heaven, earth and below. So whatever you the all the three words, anything in between also. All, and if you take 14 words, this tribhuvana is an indicative of all the 14 words as well. Basically, the universe, the teacher and the lord of the universe. Dakshinamurti Devam. Deva is Jau. Deva is derived from the dhatu, which says luster. So he has that luster. That luster is his own shine. That shine is consciousness, really. Spurti, what we call as Spurti. Swayam Prakasha. He has his own Prakasha. It is Sarupa. That Deva, who is called as Dakshinamurti, and we have seen Dakshinamurti, we will see more in the Tika. Janana Marana Dukkha Cheda Daksha. Daksha, you have seen, is Samartha, capable. Capable for what? Cheda, to shatter, cut asunder. What? Janana Marana Dukkha. Dukkha, sorrow of Janma and Marana. Basically, Samsara Dukkha. Janana Marana, when you take the beginning is Janma, Janana. Marana is death. When you take the beginning and end, anything in between is covered. So we say A to Z. A to Z does not mean only A and Z. A to Z, all alphabet, the entire alphabet is included. Similarly, here, Janana Marana means everything that comes in between. Janana Marana itself is Dukkha, and then everything in between is definitely Dukkha. There is some happiness, but a lot of sorrow. The sorrow itself, the happiness is like a cover. It's sorrow is covered with happiness. The more you indulge, the less sukha you find in each and every sequential indulgence. You need to indulge more to get the same level of pleasure that you got earlier. Why? Because samsara is dukkha rupa. Every indulgence takes you away from your atma swarupa. That swatmarama you don't have. Dakshinamurti has that swatmarama because he knows the tattva. If we don't know it, we indulge, and thereby that sukha is kind of a, it attracts you, but really there is no sukha. It is sukha vrap dukkha, so to say. So janana marana dukkha cheda daksham namami, aham namami. I bow down to that Dakshinamurti. Then chitram vatataror mule vruddha shishya guru ryuha. We have seen that, that meaning yuva. Guru is yuva, he is young, and vruddha shishya. In age as well as in jnana, they are vruddha. In all sorts of laukika jnana. This is the chitra we see. Vatataror mule. Under the banyan tree. This is the chitra that you see. Very picturesque to see this. Every time you see, this is the picture of Dakshinamurti. And guroho tu maunam vyakhyanam. His vyakhyana is mauna. We have seen mauna, all meanings of mauna. So his vyakhyana is in mauna. And shishya, what kind of shishyas are these? These shishyas, just by that mauna vyakhya, have become chinna samshayaha. All the shishyas have no doubts left at all. All their doubts are cut asunder. Therefore, they are chinna samshaya. These are people. Chinnaha samshaya yeshante chinna samshaya. Those who have lost all their doubts. Nidhaye sarva vidyanam bhishaje bhavaroginam. He is a nidhi of sarva vidya. Nidhi as in, he is a treasure of all vidya. All vidyas is a treasure of anything you want, he gives that Ishvara. Because he is in the form of everything. Whatever you ask, he is capable to give you, because it's nothing for him. For us, everything that is a huge Herculean task, for him it is nothing. He just has to manifest it. Therefore, sarva, all vidyas are, you know, they just flow from him. Thereby, he is a treasure of all vidyas. And for bhavarogis, those who do not want all the apara vidyas are something which can give you laukika good, but not the highest goal, moksha. But those who want moksha, for them, for bhavarogis, those who have this bhava or samsara roga, all of us who have samsara itself is roga, which is called as bhava. So bhavarogis, bhavaroga asya asti, or yesham asti iti bhavarogi, they have bhavaroga. So they are rogis, diseased with samsara disease. He is bhishaj, so bhishaj, bhishaje, who is a doctor, who is a doctor for bhava rogis. He cures the disease of samsara. To him, namah. So Bhishaje, namah governs fourth case. So Bhishaje, namah. And Gurave, he is also a guru. For whom? Sarvalokana. For all people, he is a guru. To that guru, namah, who is Dakshinamurti. So Gurave, Sarvalokanam Gurave, Dakshinamurte, namah. This act of bowing down or salutation or obeisance. Om namah pranavarthaya. Pranava is om. So that pranava artha, pada and padartha, there is anitya sambandha. Word and its meaning. So pranava artha, what is the meaning of pranava? What is the meaning of omkara? Omkara is everything. In fact, all Shruti derives the its power from omkara. And what is that omkara? Omkara is the bare minimum name for Ishvara is omkara. So pranava is omkara, and that pranava artha is Ishvara. It's the name of Ishvara. So pada and padartha, om and omkara artha, pranava and pranavartha. To that kind of pranavartha Dakshinamurti, my namaha. Who is what kind of murti? Shuddha jnaneka murti. He is shuddha jnana swarupa and eka. There is no other. Eka does not mean there is one Lord. There are many religions or even many philosophies within Hinduism. They say there is only one Lord. But Advaita or Shruti Tattva really says there is only Lord. So Eka means there is nothing else. There is only Lord. That Lord is Shuddha. He is Jnana. Jnana means he is consciousness. And he is Eka Tattva, Eka Murtaye. To that Murti, Dakshinamurti, Namaha, Nirmala, he is Nirmala without any Mala. There is no impurity, and not only there is no impurity, he can never get impure. He never gets affected by impurity, the way the Surya lights up all the impurities, but he is not touched by any impurities. Similarly, this Dakshinamurti is Nirmala and is Prashanta, is Prakarshana Shanta. Is completely peaceful in all kinds of situations. To that Dakshinamurti, Namaha, and he is the Adi Guru, and every Guru is considered as the manifestation of that same Lord, so that I as a Shishya can also become that. This is the Sampradaya teaching. And Ishvara, he is Ishvara, Guru Atma Iti. He is Ishvara, Dakshinamurti. He is also the Guru. And he is also Atma. Atma for everyone, Atma. Atma for everyone is I. I express myself as I. I see, I hear. So I is Atma. So how is he divided, so to say, Murti Bheda Vibhagine to that Dakshinamurti, who is Murti Bheda Vibhagi, who partakes of these kind of Bhedas of Murtis. He himself manifests in a variety of forms. What are these varieties? Ishvaraha, Guruhu, Atma. So in all these three ways, it's the same Dakshinamurti who is manifesting. To that Dakshinamurti, Murti Bheda Vibhagini, who takes up these roles, so to say, to that kind of Dakshinamurti, Namaha, who is also Vyapta Deha, who to become Ishvara, Guru and Atma, and thereby by implication, the entire prapancha, he manifests as the entire prapancha, sentient and insentient, and thereby he is all pervasive, vyapta deha. So who has a deha which is vyapta, who has his body which is vyapta, means completely pervading everything that exists. How? Vyomavat, like space. So the way space is all pervasive, he is all pervasive. In fact, he is subtler than space also, but our buddhi can go only till space, which is subtler, which is the subtlest of everything. There is nothing subtler that we can objectify. Space is something, somehow we understand space, and that space is the subtlest, which is all pervasive. So that is an example, Vyoma Vat, like Vyoma, like space, he is all pervasive, to that Dakshinamurti, Namaha. So this is the Dhyana Shloka, Lagu Tattva Sudha. Mangalacharana, we have seen Natvarabhya Lagu Vyakhyam Dakshinasha Mukha Stutehe for the stuti of Dakshinasha Mukha. So that Dakshinamurti who has his face, who faces south to that Dakshinamurti. And for that, the stuti of Dakshinamurti, I begin Natva Aham Arabhe, what? Lagu Vyakhyam. Lagu Vyakhyam Aham Arabhe. And Natva to bowing down to who? So Swayam Prakash Yati. Acharya says, Kaivalyananda Yogi, Yogindra, and Shuddhananda Yati. To these gurus, he bows down and begins the Vyakhya, which starts by saying, Iha khalu sarvajnyaha bhagavan bhashyakaraha lokanugraheka prayojana kruta sharira parigraha sakala vedanta dugdhabdehe nyayamandarena vichara nirmatanad Avirbhuta Advaitamrutasya Vinyasa Kalashabhutam Shri Dakshinamurti Stotram. We'll pause here. It's a long sentence. So, Ihakalu, here indeed, Sarvajnaha, Sarvam Janati Iti Sarvajnaha, this Bhagavan Bhashyakara, Bhagavan, who has Bhaga, all sorts of auspicious things he has. Who is this Bhashyakara? Bhashyam Karoti Iti Bhashyakara, one who has done bhashya. See, when you say bhashya, see kumbhakara, there's a word kumbhakara. Who makes kumbha? Who makes pot? So pot maker. Who do you call a pot maker? As a hobby, if you take, let's say you made a pot, saw something, YouTube video, do it yourself. So we got excited, we did it. Just by making that does not become, that person does not become a pot maker. This pratyaya used here is, it is his very shila. He is habituated to making the pot, meaning that is his main job. Nothing else is his main job. He does everything that others do too for day-to-day activities, but then his survival is on that. Or his main karya throughout the day is to make kumbha. So kumbhakara. Similarly, Bhashya, what did Adi Shankaracharya do? He took up in a very small life that he lived. He wrote Bhashyas, commentaries on Prasthanatraya. These many Upanishads, Nyaya Grantha, Brahma Sutra, and Gita, and many more works. But then, mostly he did these Bhashyas. He created these Bhashyas, therefore he is called as Bhashyakara. So, Tachilyena Karoti, Tachila, he has his habit is to write Bhashya. It becomes his second nature. Therefore, he is addressed in the Sampradaya as Bhashyakara. And since he is Bhagavan for us, he is a manifestation of the Lord. Shiva himself has taken the form. That's why also he is Bhagavan, but he gives us Bhaga. He has Bhaga and he lends us that Bhaga through his Bhashyas, therefore he is Bhagavan. And his Sarvajnaha, who can write these commentaries, who can understand what is in the Mula, which is kind of lost in the Sampradaya at his time, he has written that. So his Sarvajnaha, Sarvam Janati, he knows everything. He knows a lot more than he can let us see in the Bhashya. So we need Tikas to understand what he is trying to say. We get the basic idea. There are layers and layers. Prasanna Gambhira. It's very deep. So at any level you read the Bhashya, study the Bhashya, it is pleasant. But then it has more. It has more. It is Gambhira. So it has more and more depth in the commentaries. So that kind of Prasanna Gambhira Bhashyakara. So, tikas bring out the ideas on the Bhashya. And there are tikas upon tikas. So that kind of Bhashyakara, Bhagavan, Sarvajnaha, Sharira Parigraha. It's not one, the word is long. I'm just taking the last two words. Sharira Parigraha. He held this Sharira, means he took this avatara. Lokanugrahika Prayojana Kruta. This Sharira, what did that Sharira, what is that Sharira? That Sharira which brought about Kruta Prayojana. It brought about some benefits. For whom? Lokanugraha. What purpose was that Sharira for? That avatara was for Lokanugraha, to benefit the world. So he is called here by the Tikakara as Lokanugraheika Eka. That is the Ekameva Prayojana. There is no other Prayojana to his life. To benefit the world at large is his goal. So he is Lokanugrahika Prayojana Kruta Sharira Parigraha. He is one who has taken up the body for this purpose, only purpose. Sakala Vedanta Dukdhabdehe Nyayamandarena Vichara Nirmathanad Avirbhuta Advaitamrutasya Vinyasa Kalasha Bhutam Shri Dakshinamurti Stotram. This is the object to, in the sentence, Vyakarana. Dakshinamurti Stotra. He created Dakshinamurti Stotra. What is this Dakshinamurti Stotra itself? It has many adjectives. Sakala Vedanta Dukdhabdehe Nyayamandareda Vichara Nirmathanad Avirbhuta Advaitamrutasya Vinyasa Kalasha Bhutam. This Dakshinamurti Stotra is Vinyasa Kalasha Bhuta, meaning it is in the form of Bhuta, it is in the form of a Kalasha. The way we know Kalashas, the way in Puja you use Kalasha. So this Dakshinamurti Stotra itself is like a Kalasha. It is equated to a Kalasha, a container for Vinyasa. Vinyasa is to collect. To collect what? To collect Amruta. Amrutasya Vinyasa Kalasha Bhutam. To collect Amruta. Dakshinamurti Stotra is a container to collect Amruta. What Amruta? Advaita Amruta. And that Advaita Amruta is Avirbhuta. It has manifested. Amruta has to, if you know the Purana stories, there is an Amruta Mathana. You do the Samudra Mathana and then from that lot of things come in, but Amruta has also come for Devas. And you know that there is a struggle between Devas and Rakshasas. So this Advaita Amruta has become Avirbhuta, has manifested, has come from what kind of a Samudra? Sakala Vedanta Dugdhabdi. Ocean of milk. What is that milk? Sakala Vedanta. Entire Upanishads are called as, it's an ocean of milk of entire Vedantas. And how has this Amruta come from that ocean? There is some Mathana to be done. Nyaya Mandarena. So there is a lot of Nyaya, Tarka used to do Mathana. And that Nyaya Tarka is, there is a mountain to churn the ocean. You cannot go with a rod, a simple rod. So you need a mountain to churn, even in the Purana Katha. What is that mountain for churning this ocean? Nyaya. So Nyaya Mandara. Mandara is that it's mountain. And so through mountain of logic, what has been extracted, the essence, like the butter that we were talking about yesterday. The butter is an extract of milk, finally. Milk to curd, to buttermilk, and then the butter. That butter is the essence of that milk. So what is the essence here? This Sakala Vedanta Dugdhabdhe, the essence is this Amruta, Advaita Amruta. All Upanishads talk about Advaita. That is the goal. And therefore that is the essence. And that is Amruta. How it is derived? Through Nyaya Mandara, using that as a tool, logic as a tool, to churn this ocean of Vedanta. Vichara Nirmathanad. And that logic is there, but you have to use that logic properly. So there has to be Vichara. The logic cuts both ways. Nayayikas use the logic, but then they use logic and then they use Shruti as a secondary Pramana. But here the analysis is such that there is no contradiction possible in Shruti. And Smriti also. So that way it has to be used. So Nirmathana, the churning has to be through Vichara. Logic is only a tool. Logic cannot give you anything unless it is used properly. It is like a surgeon's knife. It can be used for good or bad. So Nyaya Mandarana Vichara Nirmathana, that is the Hetu. Due to that Nirmathana, due to that churning of the ocean using this Nyaya, Avirbhuta Advaita Amrutasya Vinyasa Kalasha Bhutam Shri Dakshinamurti Stotra. This is the Stotra, which has the essence of the Vedanta Tattva. All the Vedanta Tattvas are in this Dakshinamurti Stotra in the mere 10 shlokas. Sakala Lokanu Jigrikshaya Bhoktru Jiyo Bhogya Jagat Bhoga Prada Parameshwara Moksha Prada Guruna Atyanta Abheda Bodhakam. What else is it? It is Atyanta Abheda Bodhaka. This Stotra, since it is Advaita Amruta, what will it do? It will destroy all Bhedas. And therefore, Abheda Bodhakam, it makes you know Abheda. And is this Abheda like, okay, we are one, you know. Just this social order, you say, namesake, you know, we are all one, we are all one. But we don't act it out. It is Atyanta Abheda Bodhakam. It tells you that really there is no difference at all between Ishvara, Guru, Atma, between this, between Ishvara and me, between Ishvara and the Jagat, and between Jagat and me. At all levels, there is Atyanta Abheda. There is complete non-difference. So this stotra reveals complete non-difference. And Sakala Lokanu Jigrukshaya. So Jigruksha is Grahitum Icha, but with Anu, Anugrahitum Icha. Anu Jigruksha will be Anugrahitum Icha. Through the desire for to bring in Anugraha, benefit or welfare of all Sakala Loka, Sakala Loka. And Atyanta Abheda Bodhaka, we saw that between Ishvara and me, between Ishvara and between Jagat and me. But here what does it say? Between Bhoktru Jiva, Bhogya Jagat, Bhoga Prada Parameshwara and Moksha Prada Guru. There are four. Atyanta Abheda between whom? Bhoktru Jiva, between Jiva and, so there are four entities here. One is Jiva. The other is Jagat. Third is Parameshwara. We think sitting elsewhere. And Guru who is sitting in front of me. So there are four now. I am there. There is a Prapancha. In this Prapancha, there is a Guru. And there is a Prapancha Karta who created this world, Parameshwara. How do I understand all this? So Atyanta Abheda Bodhakam Dakshinamurti Stotram created by this Bhagavan Bhashyakara. Is this Atyanta Abheda Bodhaka which reveals complete non-difference between whom? Between this Jiva, Jagat, Parameshwara and Guru. Who are these? Who is Jiva? Bhoktru Jiva. Who is a Bhokta? I am a consumer. I experience everything. I hear, I taste all of these activities. I am a Bhokta Jiva. I suffer. I enjoy. All these are experiences. So I am a Bhokta Jiva. Who provides me this bhoga? What is the object for me? I am the subject. Bhokta is basically an upalakshana, experiencer, but basically karta also. Karta, bhokta, both are indicated. So this jiva, but why do I am a karta for what reason? I don't want to do anything just for the sake of it. I do something so that I can get some result. Therefore, bhokta. Primarily, the karta is also for bhoga only. So, for the jiva becomes a jiva for bhoga, therefore bhokta. So, bhoktru jiva, and what does he do bhoga of? Jagat. So, therefore jagat is what? Bhogya. It is something which can give me bhoga, which can be, so which is an object, bhogya. So, bhogya jagat, bhoktru jiva, bhogya jagat, and who creates this jagat, who makes it bhogya? Parameshwara. So, bhoga prada. Prakarshena dadati. He gives bhoga. Bhoga prada. Bhoga pradat. So, if you say bhoktru, similarly bhoga pradatru also you can say. That is the meaning there. Bhoga prada parameshwara. The parameshwara who gives bhoga. That kind of a parameshwara also is not different from me. And parameshwara can give bhoga. Who can give me chitta shuddhi? Can he directly give me moksha? No. That's why he has manifested as Dakshinamurti, as a teacher. Even Rama as an avatara needed Vasishta as a guru. So the Lord has to manifest and then through sampradaya teaching, therefore moksha prada, guru. Guru is moksha prada who gives moksha. And this Atyanta Abheda Bodhaka Stotra or Dakshinamurti Stotra which reveals Atyanta Abheda between all of these four. That is the kind of sotra this is, which is Advaita Amrita. Further, Sakrut Pathana Shravanartha Mananadi Matrena. परम पुरुषार्थ प्रापकम आरभमानः. एंड व्हाट इज दिस स्तोत्र? दिस स्तोत्र इज परम पुरुषार्थ प्रापक. एंड इन सेकेंड केस इट विल बिकम परम पुरुषार्थ प्रापकम बिकॉज दक्षिणामूर्ति स्तोत्रम. इन सेकेंड केस इट इज ऑल्सो एन एडजेक्टिव टू दैट परम पुरुषार्थ प्रापकम. परम पुरुषार्थ इज मोक्ष. अमोंग द फोर पुरुषार्थस धर्मार्थ काम एंड मोक्ष, मोक्ष इज ए परम पुरुषार्थ, हाईएस्ट गोल ऑफ लाइफ, रियली द ओनली गोल ऑफ लाइफ. सो दैट परम पुरुषार्थ प्रापक, इट मेक्स यू अटेन. दिस स्तोत्र मेक्स यू अटेन प्रापक, इट मेक्स यू अटेन परम पुरुषार्थ मोक्ष. हाउ? सो देयर इज अ प्रेज, सकृत पठन श्रवणार्थ मननादि मात्रेण बाय मियर मात्रा, ओनली थ्रू पठन श्रवण अर्थ श्रवणार्थ मनन आदि. सो तो श्रवण मनन निध्यासन इज द बेसिक पाथ. पठन बाय चैंटिंग, श्रवण बाय लिसनिंग टू इट, अंडरस्टैंडिंग द मीनिंग अर्थ, मनन contemplating on this, adipadena dhyana or nididhyasana, continuously meditating upon the tattva that we have understood, stotra meaning that we have understood. So should we do this continuously? The praise is sakrut. Even if you do it once, it can give you moksha. Even if you do it once, so you get people to do it, then have you got moksha? No, continue, you will get it. So slowly, and then as and so sakrat pathana, so you chanted once, but have you done shravana? No, listen to it. So do you know the artha? No. Then at least once understanding meaning. So sakrat artha also. Manana, have you done manana? So manana also once. Then adipadena nididhyasana, slowly you can bring that. But nididhyasana itself is repetition. So when you say sakrat, once at least you do nididhyasana, but that nididhyasana should be such that you understood and you meditate on that understood meaning, which itself is repetitive. So thereby, it can give you Parama Purushartha. So who is this Bhagavan Bhashyakara? So this Tikakara comes back to, this is what he is talking about. He is talking, Iha Khalu Sarvajnya Bhagavan Bhashyakara Lokanugrahika Prayojana Krita Sharira Parigraha and Arabhamanaha. Who is beginning this? Aravamana, who is beginning what? This Dakshinamurti Stotra. And what kind of Dakshinamurti Stotra? All of these adjectives. That kind of a the person who is beginning this, that kind of a Bhagavan who is beginning this kind of a Stotra. So he praised the author as well as the created work. Tikakara has done that. And Aravamana, tasya. वेदांत सारभूत नवनीत पिंडात्मकत्वेन तदीय विषयादि विहि एव तद्वत्ता सिद्धिम अभिप्रेत्य तस्य कस्य, और तस्य मींस ऑफ दैट वेदांत, व्हाट एवर इज बीइंग टॉक्ड अबाउट हियर, एंटायर सकल वेदांत दुग्धाब्धि एंड अमृत विच हैज कम अबाउट. सो यू कैन ऐड इट टू एनीथिंग, वेदांत तत्व एज वेल एज अमृत. तस्य वेदांत सारभूत नवनीत पिंडात्मकत्वेन, सो वेदांत सार, वेदांत सारभूत नवनीत, नवनीत इज बटर एंड पिंड, पिंड ऑफ नवनीत एंड आत्मकत्वेन, इन द फॉर्म ऑफ दिस पिंड ऑफ बटर, लंप ऑफ बटर. And lump of butter is a comparison to what? This Vedanta Sara. Vedanta Sara Bhuta. That which is, this butter is the essence, the way the butter is the essence of milk. Similarly, this Vedanta Sara Bhuta, this Stotra is the essence of Vedanta. Vedanta Sara Bhuta Navanita Pindatma Katvena Tadiya Vishayadi Vihyeva. Vishayadi, so Vishaya, there is a Vishaya, a subject matter for anything. There is a phala to it. And there is an adhikari. And there is prayojana. So prayojana is phala, sorry. Adhikari. And then there is a marga. Sambandha. So these are the four anubandha chatushtaya. So that can be taken there with vishayadi. तदीय विषयादि भी, तदीय तत्संबंधी वेदांत संबंधी सिंह, दिस इज अ प्रकरण ग्रंथ, स्तोत्र इज अ प्रकरण ग्रंथ, वेदांत प्रकरण ग्रंथ, इट्स एसेंस इज द सेम एज द एसेंस ऑफ उपनिषद्स. So what? Who will be the qualified? I mean, qualified person to study this? Who wants moksha ichchu? One who wants moksha, mumukshu, he is the one who is the adhikari. What is the vishaya? Same vishaya as Vedanta. Whatever is the vishaya of Vedanta, that is the vishaya here also. Basically, aikya between Parabrahma and Jiva, and we have seen aikya through this tika is explained. Atyanta veda bodhakam. So that is the prayojana there, vishaya also and prayojana also. Prayojana is moksha. Through that vishaya, jnaneva moksha really. That will give you jnana. And we say jnanena moksha. Moksha is through jnana. Ekya jnana. But jnana, then we'll say jnana you have read, that itself is moksha. There is nothing else to do. So it will lead to the sambandha also is through shravana manana nididhyasana. All these are covered. Tadiya vishayadi bhi eva tadvatta siddhim. What is the siddhi? Tadvatta Siddhi, whatever Siddhi is there through Vedanta, Shravana, Manana, Nidhyasana, Shruti, same you will get with Dakshinamurti Sotra also. So in Kannada we say Kabudad Kadle. So Shruti is very difficult, you know, to like, you know, the grains you are chewing on iron. Very difficult to understand Shruti because it's so vast. There are so many sampradayas, so to say, all tell you that this is it, this is it, bhakti, that. Nobody tells you what's the goal, final goal, which is Nitya. But Advaita Amruta, by this, it just shows that Advaita is the goal. And thereby, although we do not understand what the Shruti is saying, Dakshinamurti Sutra will make it clear because it is focusing only on that final goal. So you don't have to go through Shruti. So what is the phala? Same phala as Vedanta. Tadvatta Siddhim Avipretya Tena Tulya. Tadvatta is Tena Tulya. Tena Tulya is Vedanta Tulya. Whatever is the result, whatever is the Vishaya, whatever is the Sambandha, Adhikari and Prayojana, the same thing holds good for Dakshinamurti Stotra, being a Prakarana Grantha. And it can give you more easily compared to Shruti. So Tadvatta Siddhim Avipretya. Intending this, having intended this Avipretya, Adau, in the beginning, what does he do? Bhagavan Bhashyakara. Intending this itself, this is the goal of Dakshinamurti Stotra. These are the people I am addressing. This is how the Sambandha is and all of that holds good. Adau Pratichaha Sakala Jagat Adhishthanatvena Parameshwaratam Darshayan, showing Darshayan. Adau, in the beginning, showing what? Parameshwaratam, Parameshwara Bhava. For whom? Pratichaha. Praticha is the innermost self. Each one says I. The way a man says I, a woman also says I. The same feeling the animal also has, a bird also has. There is no difference between this I. This I is a conscious I. So that conscious I is pratyak, innermost self. So if you take away all that is different, when each and every entity says I, whatever is contradictory, you take that away, what remains is that I, the innermost self. So Pratichaha Parameshwaratam Darshayan, showing that each of these entities who thinks oneself as I, that I is Parameshwara. So Parameshwara Bhava, showing Parameshwara Bhava for that Pratyagatma, innermost self. How? Sakala Jagadadishthanatvena. This I, innermost self, is the Adishthana substratum of this entire Prapancha. So this is what Drishti Srishti Vada is. The subject who objectifies the Prapancha, he gives reality to the Prapancha. I exist. I hear. I see. I taste. I smell. I feel all this, I touch this. By doing that, I lend my satta to it. So each one's world may be different. The way you see the prapancha, the way I see the prapancha, it may be different. We may have a common ground agreement saying that this is green, this is blue, this is red. what I see, what you see, we don't know. We can't really say, but there's a general acceptance which you call as objective reality. But is it there? Is the person there next to you who says that I see this? You see the person saying and agreeing with you. The way you give reality to the prapancha, similarly you are giving the reality to the other also. So that is the basis for this, to say that sakala jagada adhishthanatvena, as the adhishthana pratich pratyangatma by, see, Parameshwara, we know that he is the adhishthana of the prapancha. He has created this world. And therefore the entire prapancha rests on this person. Which person? The supreme reality, the supreme person, Ishwara. But Pratichaha Parameshwarataam. Tikakara says that he shows aikya between the Lord and this innermost self. How? As an adhishtana of the entire prapancha. How so? Parameshwara I understand, but how am I an adhishtana? I give my satta to this prapancha by interacting, by objectifying the world itself, I give it satta and spurana. So the satta, the existence is lent, the spurana, the sentience is also lent to the prapancha by the mere act of objectifying it. When you wake up, you objectify something, it becomes real. Was it real when you went to deep sleep? Yes, it was there. My brother told me when I woke up. My wife told me. My husband, my children told me that the prapancha was there. Do you know what happened when you fell asleep? All this happened. How do you know it happened? Someone says. Who is that someone? I objectify. Was that someone there when you were asleep? Someone else has to tell you that that someone who tells you that the world exists, existed. How do you know that the second person who tells you that that person who objectified the world when you went asleep existed? Need someone else? Ad infinitum, infinite regress, a flaw in logic. So who gives the person a reality to make the world real? I do it. When I wake up, I give reality to the prapancha as well as the objectifier of the prapancha, as well as someone who tells me that there is this prapancha existed when you went to sleep. But what do I really know? I know that I existed. I am existing. I don't need any pramana. No one can tell me that, oh, you are asleep right now, that you are blabbering in your sleep. I know. Even if I am blabbering in my sleep, I am there. So I am there. That I needs no other pramana. It is Swata Siddha. I know myself by myself. This is the only thing I, which you can say is idam ittham. It is exactly the way I know myself. As existent. Not with this body, mind, sense complex, because that was not there in my deep sleep. Is this prapancha real? It's as real as your swapna prapancha. In the dream, you felt the dream world as real as this waking world. What is the difference between the two? So we'll see more. Praticha sakala jagadadishthanatvena parameshwarataam darshayan bhagavan bhashyakaraha dakshinasha mukham parameshwaram manasa pujayati. Adav, in the beginning, pujayati, he worships, praises, dakshinasha mukham, parameshwaram, he praises or worships this parameshwara, the highest lord there is nothing beyond this lord, who is dakshinamurti, who is facing dakshinasha mukham, dakshinamurtim. And to do what? He is showing aikya. Pujayati, how? Manasa, through the mind. Manasika puja, he is not using flowers and he is not using kumkuma, dhupa, nevidya, nothing. Manasa pujayati. Why? Because this prapancha, this manifestation is in the mind. The puja has to be in the mind. Even when you are really offering flowers, Flowers are also manasika really. This is the underlying current there. Undercurrent in the shloka there. Before that, Vishwamithi. So Vishwamithi, it's the shloka starts with Vishwam. We'll also do Mangalacharana and a little bit. We see the introduction of Manasollasa also, so that we have a taste for it. Then we'll go into whichever tika makes we can cover. Mangalam dishatu me Vinayakaha, Mangalam dishatu me Saraswati, Mangalam dishatu me Maheshwaraha, Mangalam dishatu me Sadashivaha. Simple. So it's Mangalam dishatu me Vinayakaha, me Vinayaka, Ganesha. Bestow Mangala, auspiciousness upon me, says Bhagavan Sureshwaracharya. And similarly, Saraswati, Maheshwaraha and Sadashivaha. He praises, he asks for blessings from all the deities. Atmalabhat parolabha nasti iti munayo viduhu. Tallabhartam kavistauti swatmanam parameshwaram. Stauti, kavi hi stauti. The kavi, kavi is the author. Bhagavan Vashyakara, Bhagavat Padacharya, Adi Shankaracharya, stauti, he praises. The kavi praises Parameshwaram. Whom does he praise? He praises Parameshwara. Who is this Parameshwara? Swatmanam, one's own self. Sureshwaracharya also in the first shloka itself, he says, he praises the Lord. Who is not elsewhere? Swatma. He is myself. He praises himself, who is the Lord. For what purpose? Tallabhartham. For attainment of that. What is that? That is in the first line. Atmalabhat paraha labha nasti iti munayaha viduhu. I am not saying it. Says Bhagavan Sureshwara says, Munis say, Munis are those who are mananashila, they know this reality tattva. They say, Atmalabhat paralabha nasti. There is nothing superior to Atmalabha. One's own attainment is the highest attainment. There is nothing beyond this. This is the goal of all life. Therefore, Tallabhartham. Therefore, for attainment of that, Atmalabha. What does Kavi do? Swatmanam Parameshwaram Stauti. He praises the Lord who is not different from oneself. Svechaya srushtam avishya vishvam yo manasisthitah stotrena stuyatenena saeva parameshwarah. Who is this Parameshwara? Saeva Parameshwara. He is Parameshwara. Who is that? Svechaya srushtam vishvam avishya. This vishwa, having entered this vishwa, having created it, he entered. Who? Parameshwara. Parameshwara created this prapancha. Creation is manifestation. He manifested this prapancha out of himself, which itself is the act of entering that prapancha. A part of prapancha that he entered became the jiva. The entire is called as Ishvara. And that which appears as sentient, ancient, other than me, beyond my tips of the nails, that I called as Jagat. It is all Ishvara. So, the same Ishvara, Saheva Parameshwara, who Swechaya, through his own Ichha, he manifested. He just desired that may I become many, and he became as though many. He is not really become many. He appears to be many. Yaha manasi sthitaha. And in each and every mind, he exists. How? As a sakshi. Aham, aham. I. That is this Parameshwara. Anena stotrena, saeva Parameshwara stuyate. That same Parameshwara who is a creator and also a jiva, through this stotra, he is praised. Stuyate. So you made this, the right side is empty. So you can write on the right side as well. You can refer on the left side and write on the right side as well. More space. Asti prakashati iti vyavahara pravartate. Tachastitvam prakashatvam kasminarthe pratishtitam. Kinteshu teshu varteshu kimva sarvatmanishvare ईश्वरत्वं च जीवत्वं सर्वात्मत्वं च कीदृशं जानीयात् कथं जीवः किंत ज्ञानस्य साधनं ज्ञानात् तस्य फलं किं स्याद् एकत्वं च कथं भवेत् सर्वज्ञः सर्वकर्ता च कथं आत्मा भविष्यति शिष्यं प्रतीत्थं पृच्छन्तं वक्तुम् आरभते गुरुः. सो एज एन इंट्रोडक्शन टू दिस फर्स्ट श्लोका व्हाट डज भगवान भाष्यकार भगवान सुरेश्वराचार्य से is also called as Vartikakara, Sureshwaracharya. So what does Bhagavan Vartikakara say? He says this stotra is an answer of the guru to the shishya, his teaching. And the shishya who now through this praise, anena stotrena sahayo parmeshwara stuyate, this parmeshwara who is jiva is praised. So you are telling me that jiva and parmeshwara is one? So the shishya asks, asti prakashate iti vyavahara pravartate. Asti, this prapanchaya exists and I can see, I can objectify, I can feel, so bhati also, so here prakashate, iti vyavahara, there is a vyavahara, there is a, you use this word and you express this, that I see this, it exists, this world exists and I can interact with it. Tatcha astitvam and prakashatvam, that existence of this prapancha and how it reveals itself to me. That revelation. Kasmin arthe pratishtitam. What is the basis for this? What is the basis to for this world to exist and for it to reveal to me? How I can I interact this prapancha that is existent? What is the basis for all this? This is the Shishya's question. What else? He says, Kin teshu teshu arteshu kimva sarvatmani ishware ishvaratvam cha jivatvam sarvatmatvam cha kidrusham. Ishvara, Jiva, then Sarvatma Bhava, all that you talk about when everything is one, that Sarvatma Bhava. How is it? I don't understand all this. And Kim Teshu Teshu Artheshu Kimva Sarvatmani Ishvare. In this Ishvaratvam, Jivatvam, Sarvatmatvam, this is with, when you deal with each and every object of the world, you are talking about this Prapancha. So in each of these, and in with respect to Ishvara, all of these bhavas, ishvaratvam, jivatvam, in what way is all this? I want to understand this vyavastha, asks the shishya. Further he says, jivaha katham janiyat kim tajnyanasya sadhanam. How should we know all this that you are teaching and what is the means to know this aikya? Tajnyanasya sadhanam kim? What is the means to this? Jnanatasya phalam kim syat? What is the phala? What is the resultant of this jnana, aikya that you are teaching? I should get some benefit. I am spending some time. Shravana manana nidhi, so much of effort. What is the labha? What is the phala? And ekatvam cha katham bhavet. When you are talking about ekatva, how is it possible? Aikya. Parameshwara is sarvajnya. I am alpajnya. So many differences are there. How is this ekatvam possible? What is the means? How do we get this knowledge? What is the phala of this knowledge? All this he is asking. Sarvajnya sarvakarta cha atma katam bhavishyati. How will this atma become sarvajnya? Bhagavan is sarvajnya. You are saying I am Bhagavan, Ishvara. So sarvajnya and sarvakarta. Not only I know sarvakarta because svechaya, through his own ichha, Parameshwara has created this word. So ichha shows jnana. He has jnana. But he is also sarvakarta, is created. Not only did he desire, but he manifested this prapancha. And when you say, I am that Parameshwara, then I will become Sarvajna. I should know everything. And then I should also be Sarvakarta because he is Sarvakarta. So Sarvajna Sarvakarta cha katam atma bhavishyati. How will I be all of that you are talking about? Shishyam prati, towards the Shishya, ittham pruchyantam, who is asking in this manner all these set of questions, vaktum guruhu aravate, to answer the Shishya, all of these questions are being answered. To answer that, he begins. Guru begins the teaching.
Vishwam darpana drishyamana nagari tulyam nichantargatam.
Vishwam darpana drishyamana nagari tulyam nichantargatam.
Pashyannatmani mayaya bahirivod bhutain yatha nidraya.
Pashyannatmani mayaya bahirivod.
यः साक्षात् कुरुते प्रबोध समये स्वात्मानमेवाद्वयम् तस्मै श्रीगुरुमूर्तये नम इदम् श्रीदक्षिणामूर्तये So this is the refrain through all the 9 shlokas. The 10th shloka has a different ending. But Tasmai Shri Guru Murte Idam Namaha. Tasmai Shri Dakshina Murtaye Guru Murtaye. Or Tasmai Shri Dakshina Murtaye Shri Guru Murtaye Idam Namaha. This Namaskara of mine is to whom? To that Dakshina Murti, Shri Dakshina Murti. Who is Shri Guru Murti, who is also the teacher, who is the Guru. And this refrain is there through the next 8 shlokas. Who is this? Pashyan. This Guru is seeing. This Dakshina Murti, who is Guru, he is Pashyan. He is seeing. What is he seeing? Vishwam. He is seeing this world. So Shishya is asking, I see this prapancha. Who is seeing this prapancha? The Lord is seeing this prapancha. Through his Ichha is created. He himself is seeing this prapancha. As and when he objectifies the prapancha, he has this individuality. Because this object and subject division is created. Thereby, somehow he thinks that I am a limited entity and becomes a jiva. This is avidya. The same Parameshwara, Dakshinamurti, having created this prapancha through his Ichha, he objectifies this prapancha and he thinks that I am a jiva. Vishwam Pashyan, where? Atmani. How has he really created this prapancha also? Before he becomes a jiva, he has to really create this prapancha as well. So how has he created this prapancha? Pashyan, seeing this, the desire itself is creation. Ichha is creation. Seeing is creation. So, Vishwam Pashyan. How? As the outside. Bahiriva. Udbhutam. As though manifesting outside. It is not really outside. See, Bhagavan has nothing outside. The Ishwara, Dakshinamurti. Who is Ishwara? How does he create this prapancha? Let's say he created this prapancha from something. We'll have to ask, what is the material? So if you say he created out of something, what is that something? Is it inside or outside? If it is outside, then he is not Ishwara. He is limited by that outside. Because there is an outside, he is limited by space also. So what did he create it from? He created it from himself. So if he created it from himself, this prapancha is divided from him. Did he take a part of him and create prapancha? If that is so, then what remains is Ishwara. Now, thereby also is limited. But the Shruti says that he is Purna. He is Purna before creation. He is Purna during creation. He is Purna after creation. He is Purna after resolution, during sustenance. All the time is Nitya and Purna. How is it possible? It is possible only when this creation is in his mind. When you create in your mind, there is no division. Then only you can be Purna. So Prapancha is created. This Vishwa is Pashyan, seeing this Vishwa, Nijantargatam, which is always within him. It is not really outside. He didn't create it outside. He sees it as it is, as if it is outside. So Dakshinamurti Ishwara Vishwam Pashyan. What is this Vishwa now? Seeing it. How can you see it within? Darpana Drishyamana Nagri Tulyam Vishwam. This Vishwa is Tulya, comparable to Darpana Drishyamana Nagri, like a city which can be seen in the darpana, in the mirror. So the example should be taken only up to that extent. In the example, in the illustration, there is a darpana There is a city outside. That city appears inside. But it appears inside. It exists outside. Here it is opposite. It appears inside. It exists inside. It appears outside. So darpana eva. But what happens when you're seeing? But example you take, you see in the darpana. If you want to take the exact example would be you see your face inside the mirror. The person, the entire person, the, if you see a life-size mirror and you see yourself within, there is no person within or without. Really, there is nothing separate from you. But if you look at that person within and you think that there is a person, someone different from you, you lose sight of that. And then you think that there is someone really existent there who may be elsewhere. I don't know who is that person. So that image confuses us. If you take that kind of an example, understanding of this, then this this nagri is similar to that. That prapancha is similar to that nagri which is visible inside. But it is not really existent outside. Therefore, bahir iva udbhutam. This vishwam is bahir iva. Like, eva is means like, as though outside, bahihi, as though outside, although it is not outside, as though manifest outside, udhutam. Pashyan, seeing this, he sees within and somehow he gets confused due to avidya that it is outside. So, bahiriva udhutam, pashyan. But it is, this vishwa is what? Really, nija antargatam. It is always within. That's why there is no bheda possible, there is no division possible. There cannot be an aropa made thus this prapancha and Ishvara are different. Ishvara is imagining it in his own mind and he sees as though outside. Now he does not get confused. That's why we call him as Ishvara. Through his Maya Shakti, he makes it appear as though. And the same Dakshinamurti who becomes non-Ishvara as though, under the influence of avidya and thinks that what is seen outside is real, he becomes as though segmented, as though a jiva, and then another and yet another and yet another, and then there is samsara for that jiva. So vishwam darpana drishyamana nagari tulyam, which is really nijantargatam. And not to get confused with this example, he gives another example. Bhairiva. How is that possible? Udbhutam yatha nidraya. Just like in sleep, in dream. When you go to sleep, so this darpana drishyamana nagri tulyam can be interpreted literally. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara knows that and he gives another example. Yatha nidraya. Because someone may ask, the shishya may ask, oh, but in darpana I see it is real outside. How do you say that tulya? It is not tulya. It is tulya. You have to understand the example. If you don't understand it, I'll give you a better example. He says, yatha nidraya. Do you see the prapancha the way you see in the mirror in the dream? Because it is within. And that prapancha is like it is outside. Because you interact. You don't know that you are dreaming. The dreamer does not know. The dreamer is a waker in the dream. And he can become another dreamer by dreaming within the dream, which he thinks is waking. So, yatha nidraya bahiriva udbhutam pashyan. This swapna drashta, the person who is dreaming. Similarly is this creation. But when one wakes up, I wake up from the dream, then I know, oh, there was no prapancha. The swapna prapancha was not really outside at all. It was within. And was it within some time during the dream? Nijantargatam, continuously, as long as a person is dreaming, this entire prapancha is outside. And in that dream, the sharira is also created. That sharira is all not within. When I say I the dreamer, when I wake up, I say I as a dreamer, that I as a dreamer, that I think as a waker, I know that dreamer, sharira, this prapancha as well as the sharira was all created, imagined in the mind. Sharira was imagined, all the shariras, the way they were imagined, sentient or insentient. Similarly, my Sharira was also imagined in my own mind. But when do I know that? Prabodha Samaye, when I wake up. So this Dakshinamurti is one who wakes up. Prabodha Samaye, Sakshat Kurute, Yaha, Sakshat Kurute, one who makes it immediate. He does not think, you don't wake up and ask, oh, did I dream yesterday? Nobody knows what you dreamt. You know that you dreamt. You wake up and you know. There is nothing else needed. Shuddha Jnana. You wake up and you know the entire mithyatva, that all that prapancha that you dreamt of was not real, even a bit. Not only during waking, not only when you woke up, but you know that it was unreal even when it felt very real during the dream period. Similarly, Prabodha Samaye, the way a waker knows at the time of waking the mithyatvam of the Swapna Prapancha, similarly, this waking Prapancha is known as mithya when there is jnanopatti. So when one wakes up to the tattva, reality of the Jagat, Ishvara and Atma, also Guru. So yaha sakshat kurute prabodha samaye, what does he make immediate? That atmanam, swatmanam, advayam. This atma can never be segmented. It was not only non-dual, it can never become a second. That kind of advaya atma, he makes it immediate. I know it makes it immediate means there's no making anything. It is immediate. So sakshatkara is sakshat kurute. It's an interesting usage there. Kurute. Kru dhatu is an ubhayapati dhatu. Ubhayapati means it can use parasmai pada as well as atmane pada forms. It can take both. So generally it is said that generally in vyakarana, when a particular verb can take parasmai pada and atmane pada form, then that dhatu, the kriya indicated by dhatu. Here the kriya is what? Kru, dukrunj karane, karane, to do something. So whenever that activity of doing something gives the result to oneself only, not to anyone else, then atmane pada is used. Atmane padam pratyaya is used. And when it brings in phala to anyone else other than me also, then parasmi pada form is used. Here, there is an interesting atmane pada use. So it's a giveaway that this Dakshinamurti is doing it for himself. He is not doing for others. He himself has become baddha as though. He himself has become free as though. Why? Advaya, there is no one else to become baddha. There is no one else. There is only Ishvara. When you say there is no one else, only Ishvara, Advaita Sattva, how can there be a Jiva separate? There is no Jiva separate. This Jiva is just an appearance of the same Dakshinamurti. Therefore, Sakshat Kurute. Prabhodha Samaye Sakshat Kurute Advayam Atmanam, Svatmanam, one's own self. And one's own means, we have seen Raho Shirava Shashti. He is the self, Advaya self. Non-dual, Advitiya or Advaya self, to that Dakshinamurti, who is what? Who is Guru Murti? Who himself has become the Guru, Adi Guru, and in the Sampradaya, who has all the same Guru, Dakshinamurti, manifests as a Guru, who is also a Jiva. Because it tells that Vishwam Darpana Drishyamanandigri Tulyam Nijantargatam Pashyan, when Bahiriva Pashyan, Mayaya, due to Maya. Maya is also Avidya. Through that Ishvara Shakti, which is Maya, which has two Shaktis, Avarna Shakti and Vikshepa Shakti, which reveals the Tattva, reality, and projects something else. As though outside. So what is inside is covered. What is me, I myself am veiled to me. And then there is a projection as though it is real. This appears outside. So the same Tattva appears as though outside. Imagined, unreal imagination within appears outside. So if anyone tried the exercise in the meditation in the morning, you imagine a vriksha, it appears outside. But as soon as it is gone, you remain. So this Dakshinamurti who imagined this prapancha, like that vriksha in the meditation, goes away suddenly. Prabodha samaye. Due to maya, it appeared outside. It gives you the shakti. Maya is avidya shakti, which gives you a power to imagine also and project outside. That becomes our reality, the daydreaming. Even daydreaming, why should you dream only after sleeping? Daydreaming also, you don't know where you are. That becomes a reality. That tells you, swapna prapancha, daydreaming, and this, it is a possibility that this prapancha is a dream. For Dakshinamurti, but why do I see it? Because Advaya, there is no difference between him and me. Therefore, I see this prapancha. And he himself makes it immediate. This knowledge becomes immediate to him. Prabodha samaye, at waking, in the example, and also that example is extended to say on jnanotpatti, when jnana takes place, advaita jnana, to that Dakshinamurti, who is Guru Murti, idam namaha, this salutation of mine or obeisance of mine. We'll see the tika in the next part. कैवल्यानंद योगींद्र शुद्धानंद यतीश्वरो नत्वारवे लघु व्याख्याम दक्षिणाशा मुखस्तुते तत्सत्